Welcome to The Terrible Take, a daily segment telling Steelers Nation what's on our mind. I'm Dave Bryan. Sunday's game between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Cleveland Browns now serves as a very good example as to why an archaic stat such as yards per carry really shouldn't be trusted. And here's why. Looking at the running back carries only from that Sunday game between the Steelers and the Browns, and you will notice that Cleveland compiled 86 rushing yards on just 21 running back carries, while Pittsburgh registered 89 yards on 28 running back carries. The yards per carry stats for those running back totes come out to be 4.1 for the Browns versus 3.2 for the Steelers. That obviously means that the Browns' running game on Sunday, at least when it comes to the running backs, was better than the Steelers, right? Well, advanced metrics, notably successful run rates, tells us that's not indeed the case. Before we go any further, I wanted to let everyone know what I deem to be a successful run, and it's based on a simple formula that Chase Stewart from Pro Football Perspective developed years ago. In short, any run that achieves 40% or more of the yardage needed on first down is deemed a successful run. If 50% or more of the yardage needed on second down is achieved, that is also deemed a successful run. When it comes to third and fourth downs, achieving 100% or more of the yardage needed on those two downs constitutes a successful run. Also, as Stewart's formula points out, any run 6 yards or longer is automatically counted as being successful. With that successful run rate formula now recapped, we can quickly review the successful run rates for the running backs from Sunday's game between the Steelers and the Browns. The Browns running backs combined to have just 6 successful runs on Sunday for a lowly 28.6% success rate. The Steelers running backs, on the other hand, combined to have 12 successful runs, good for a success rate of 42.9%. So, the Steelers easily had the better successful run rate of the two teams, and it really wasn't close. I hope this all makes sense and helps in the fight to get people to move away from using yards per carry as a stat that holds much water. While we are on the subject of successful run rates, I thought now would be a perfect time to recap the rate that Steelers rookie running back Najee Harris posted in the month of October. Harris, who was named the NFL's Rookie of the Month for October on Thursday, posted a successful run rate of 59.1% last month on 88 total carries. That's quite an impressive rate and well above 50%, which is really the watermark level that all running backs should strive to be above. Be sure to follow us at SteelersDepot.com and check out episodes of The Terrible Take every day at 5 p.m. Eastern Time. And check out The Terrible Podcast with myself and Alex Cazora every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday.